Yeah, listen, love, can you check his diary for me? I need a window to put a name to him for Swastika Robots 3. Eh? What do you mean, what part? The male lead. Forgot his name, hang on a tick. What's the name of your character?
Jane. Jarvis McDonald.
Sorry, Jack, sweetheart. Listen, it's Jarvis McDonald. Eh? You sure? Hold on a second. You schmuck. She says Jarvis McDonald's the effeminate hairdresser who gets murdered in the first wheel. Look again, will ya? And this time, look at the top of the list and not at the bottom.
No, sorry, Elvis O'Grady.
Yeah, that sounds more like it. Hello, Jax? This is sweetheart. Yeah, it's Elvis O'Grady. Is it roll up for grabs? Oh, shit. Really? Alright, thanks anyway. Yeah, we'll bear it in mind. Yeah. Sorry, son. Roll's gone.
Shoot, too.
Loafer Red Sauce, would you believe? Apparently, he changed his mind and decided to do it. Anyways, don't get too upset, old son. Jack says that the Jarvis McDonald role was still open.
I play no upsell.
Well, there is always the role of second robot.
Second robot? I don't remember seeing that. What sort of role was that anyway?
Well, the sort of role that would suit you, Craig. It's a role that demands a great physical presence. A strong silent type, say, like Christopher Lee or the in the Dracula films, or the closest thing I can think of is Darth Vader.
What, like in Star Wars, yeah?
Yeah? Right. Now he was played by Dave Prowse. But he didn't do the voice. That was done by James Earl Jones. He, like you will be, was required for his physical presence only.
Oh, right. So I'm playing Darth Vader, yeah?
What? No, you're playing...
I'm playing Darth Prowse, aren't I?
Jesus Christ! Don't we just say you'll play Darth Bastard? After all, that's your natural role, isn't it?
Sorry, I don't remember. Was that Harrison Ford or his hirsute sidekick?
Suit.
Yeah, it means airy.
Airy.
Yes.
Shut the fuck up.
So let's talk about some of the films you've made in recent years to try and raise your profile in America. There was, for example, Star Trek IX: Sulu's Malady.
Yeah, that was a laugh.
In it, you played a Klingon guard, two lines, I believe.
One actually.
Now, that was quite a small part, but it did introduce you to some interesting contacts, I imagine.
Interesting contacts indeed, as Craig is asked to audition for the transvestite flick, Daphne, Queen of the Desert.
Hello,
Lindsay
Craig.
Yeah, pleased to meet you.
Right. Eric, Craig's agent. Right, Craig. Splendid outfit, by the way. Look, I don't know much you know about this project. Not much, I suppose. The idea of today really is for me to see you act out a couple of pieces to see how you may fit in. Happy with that?
What you got to understand, Damien, is that Craig don't normally do this sort of stuff. Normally a director will look at his mug and the size of his chest and they just sign him up on the spot.
Yeah, I understand it, Eric, but the fact is that if Craig wants a spot in this movie, he's going to have to show me what he can do, okay?
Well, okay.
Yeah? Yeah, okay, good, right. Okay, Craig, what I'd like you to do, please, is take a look through this, take a couple of seconds to read through it, and then give your interpretation, all right?
Yeah, well, I'm not sure about this. I don't understand any of it.
Yeah, you're quite jelly. What the fuck's this? What is Shimmy and Sashay around the room imagining you're miming to an ABBA track, mate? Huh?
Well, exactly that. I mean, what do you think, Craig? Do you want to give it a crack?
Well, I don't know. What does Sashay mean then?
Well, look. Look, I mean, would it help if we actually put the track on, you know, to give you something to work on?
Well, yeah, I suppose so, yeah.
Dandy. Okay, Craig. Just for you. Let's see what we can do.
Christ, Craig, get out of the way,
I show
what I mean.
Here.
What is all this, pal?
Yeah, where's Tina Turner?
Hang on a minute. Tina Turner?
Yeah.
You want to mind the Tina Turner? Well, look, she doesn't really fit into this movie.
No, I mean, I thought she'd be here.
Yeah. I mean, why should Tina Turner be here of all places?
Well, isn't she definitely Queen of the Desert, you know, like Auntie Entity in Mad Max 3 Beyond Thunderdome?
What are you on, pal? Do you know what this film's about?
Jesus.
Well, it sounded like a sort of Mad Max type thing to me.
Oh, right, I get it. Like with Tina Turner as Daphne and you as Mel Gibson, right?
Right.
And T.T. singing We Don't Need No Hero, right?
Right.
Wrong, Buster. With you, it would be We Don't Need Another Meeting. Now get out of here, time-wasting pummy bastard.
Look, we don't understand! What is this film all about?
Right. It's about three drag queens who go on a quest to Central Australia on a coach which they christen Daphne, Queen of the Desert.
Yeah, so,
Hey, I'm sitting here!
You know, in this film, what sort of part was I down to play then?
Well, you're auditioning for one of the tranny parts, you know, one of the drag queens.
Yeah. Hope you're not insinuating that my Quag is a shirt lifter.
Nothing so interesting, pal. There's a vacuum on the end that's frightening.
Yeah, are you calling me a nonce?
Oh, get a life, love. You're an actor, aren't you?
Yeah, of course I am.
Of course he is.
But Craig, love, I think this role would require to act beyond your range.
You Aussie poof. Quag is top wank.
Yes, Eric, I'm afraid that's all too obvious.
Wank, I said, not wank!
Look, Eric, I can tell you're trying to hammer home the point, but there really is no need. The fact broadcasts itself.
You snide bastard! What?
Bill! Bill! Right, son, you're going to die for this, and I'm your assassin!
Excellent. Tell me, is that an original or is that from a Seagal movie? Belinda, call security, get these two arseholes out of here now, thank you.